Welcome back to my channel. Everkum ende channel like swagatham. So today I am going to present before you some of the job offers of GCC and the materials are provided by Connect West Gateway HR Consultancy. So this consultancy is providing many services like data flow, credential, and even they are giving coaching for many of the licensing exam for other specialties like nursing, pharmacy, dentistry. So I'll be putting the email address as well as the contact number of this consultancy in my description box so that you can directly contact them. And along with that, we will be discussing the question and answers of our specialty. Since many of the exams are uplifting, ഒരുപാട് വ്യൂവേഴ്സ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരുപാട് ഫ്രണ്ട്സ് എന്നോട് റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തു കുറച്ച് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസും ആൻസേഴ്സും ഒക്കെ ഇൻക്ലൂഡ് ചെയ്യാമോ, കാര്യം മെഡിക്കൽ കോളേജ് PSC എക്സാംസ് എല്ലാം കോൾ ഫോർവേഡ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്, കുറച്ച് ടോപ്പിക്സിൻ്റെ ക്ലാസ്സുകൾ വെക്കാമോ എന്നൊക്കെ ചോദിച്ചു ഒരുപാട് പേര് റിക്വസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. അതിൻ്റെ ഫലമായിട്ട് ഇനി വരും സെഷനുകളിൽ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യനും ആൻസേഴ്സും ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുന്നതായിരിക്കും. അത് നിങ്ങളുടെ PSC എക്സാംസിന് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഹാർഡ് എക്സാം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു DHE എക്സാംസിന് എല്ലാം ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്യും. കാര്യം ഒരു പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ടോപ്പിക്കും അതിനെ ബേസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള MCQs ആണ് ഞാൻ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുക. Along with that, I will be giving a brief explanation. അപ്പോൾ ആ ഒരു പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യനും അതിൽ ഒരു ബ്രീഫ് എക്സ്പ്ലനേഷനും കൂടെ ആകുമ്പോൾ അത് വേറൊരു രീതിയിൽ ചോദിച്ചാലും എങ്ങനെ അതിൻ്റെ ആൻസർ ചെയ്യാം എന്നുള്ളതിൻ്റെ ഒരു എക്സ്പ്ലനേഷൻസും ആയിരിക്കും കൊടുക്കുക. അപ്പോൾ അത് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരുപാട് ഉപയോഗപ്രദമായിരിക്കും, നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരുപാട് ആ ഒരു പർട്ടിക്കുലർ ടോപ്പിക്കിനെ പറ്റി മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ സാധിക്കും. സോ ടുഡേ ഐ ഹാവ് ഇൻക്ലൂഡഡ് MRI. Some of the question and the answers MCQs I have included of the topic MRI, so it will be very helpful for you. So patiently watch till the end and stay tuned. Let us begin today's sessions. The materials are provided by Connect West Gateway HR Consultancy. The first vacancy is for nurses with UAE-MOH for government COVID projects in Sharjah, Ajman, Rasam Khaima, Umman Huyin, and this is a free recruitment and the salary offered is ₹7,000 to ₹10,000. All facilities will be provided, both male and female can apply. You can send your resumes at careers@cwghr.com. The next vacancy is for pharmacist. The qualification can be B-Pharm or D-Pharm. The salary offered is ₹3,500 AED to ₹4,000 AED. Both male and female can apply, and those who are outside UAE can attend interview through online, and you may send your resumes at careers@cwghr.com. The next vacancy is also for nurses, site nurses, and the qualification is BSc. License is HAD and the salary offered is ₹7,000 AED to ₹8,000 AED, and for this vacancy only males can apply, and those who are outside UAE can attend interview through online, and you may send your resumes at careers@cwghr.com. The next vacancy is also for nurses. For school nurse in UAE, only female candidates can apply. Qualification is BSc and the license is HAD and the salary offered is ₹7,000 to ₹8,000 AED, and you may send your resumes at careers@cwghr.com, and those who are outside UAE can attend interview through online. Part 5 exam tips for radiography. Moving on to the 16th question, increasing the magnetic field, these are the options. Option A produces less susceptibility artifacts, option B reduces the risk of tissue heating, option C increases the signal to noise, and option D means reduces the danger from metallic objectiles. The answer is option C, increase the signal to noise, means increasing the magnetic field means increase the signal to noise. Let's see the explanation. Signal to noise ratio means SNR is used to describe the performance of an MRI system. An MRI image is not created by pure MRI signal,
but from a combination of MRI signals and unavoidable background noise. In MRI, the SNR is mainly used for image evaluation and measurement of contrast enhancement, pulse sequence and radio frequency, means the RF coil comparison and quality assurance. To the next question, question number 17. This is whether to determine whether it is true or false, that is T1 increases with magnetic field. Option A, false, and option B, true. So the answer is option B, true, since the T1 increases with magnetic fields. Let's see the question. How do T1 and T2 values vary as the function of field strength? The unit for the magnetic field strength is Tesla. You might have already heard about 3 Tesla and 1.5 Tesla. So with respect to that, I am giving a brief explanation. T1 increases with field strength and T2 doesn't change very much as field strength increases. So when the field strength, when the Tesla increases, T1 increases and T2 doesn't change. And this can be understood by reviewing the principle underlying dipole-dipole interaction and the primary mechanism responsible for T1 and T2 relaxation rates for hydrogen nuclei. We will be discussing about T1 and T2 in the next coming slides. So, the next question, question number 18. How is proton density weighting achieved? Option A, short TR and long TE. Short TR means repetition time and TE is the time to echo. Option B, long TR and short TE. Option C, short TR and short TE. So the answer is B, long TR and short TE. Long TR means long repetition time and short time to echo or the echo time. So let's see the explanation. Proton density PD refers to the concentration of protons in tissue. Protons being the hydrogen nuclei that resonate and give rise to NMR signal, that is nuclear magnetic resonance. So since the human body comprises of 90% of water, the chemical formula for water is H2O. So NMRI principle mainly depends upon this hydrogen proton. TR and TE are the basic pulse sequence parameters and stand for repetition time. Repetition time means repetition of the pulse sequences is the TR and TE is the echo time. They are usually measured in milliseconds. A long TR and a short T, when the repetition time is long and the echo time is short, then it is a PD weighted image. Both TR and TE short, then it is a T1 weighted image. When both TR and TE is long, it is a T2 weighted image. Question number 19, what is a T2 star? Option A, a time constant describing the exponential decay of signal due to spin lattice interactions. Option B, a time constant describing the exponential decay of signal due to spin-spin interactions, magnetic field inhomogeneities and susceptibility effects. Option C, a time constant describing the exponential decay of signal due to spin-spin interactions. So the answer is option B, a time constant describing the exponential decay of signal due to spin-spin interactions, magnetic field inhomogeneities and susceptibility effects. Let's see the explanation. A T2 weighted image is one of the basic pulse sequence of MRI. The sequence weighting highlights the differences on the T2 relaxation time of tissues. Repetition time TR long, echo time TE is long. When TR and TE is long, then it is a T2 weighted image. Flip angle is less important than with T1 weightening. Fat will be seen as intermediate bright and the fluid will be seen as hyperdense. That means bright. MRI usually deals with this hydrogen nuclei. Since our human body comprises of 90% of water, the chemical formula for water is H2O, so it deals with this hydrogen nuclei. So when a patient is coming under a magnetic field, before coming under a magnetic field, these protons will be randomly arranged. And when this patient comes under a magnetic field, these protons will be aligned in parallel as well as anti-parallel direction. Parallel means spin up and anti-parallel means spin down and will be having different energy. The orientation that is parallel to B0, B0 means the main magnetic field is of low energy than that of anti-parallel orientation, and it is known as the longitudinal magnetization, and it depends upon the external magnetic field strength. So when we are giving an RF pulse, this longitudinal magnetization, suppose this longitudinal magnetization as in the XY direction, when we are giving this RF pulse, this longitudinal magnetization will flip from the direction towards the transverse magnetization, means to the Z direction it will be flipping. So when we switch off this RF pulse, this spin will be refacing back to the longitudinal magnet, means relaxing back to the main magnetic field. At the time of this relaxation, echo is produced. So it is known as the echo time or time of echo, and the repetition of this RF pulse is known as the TR. As that we have discussed before, when it is a long TR and a long TE means it is a T2 weighted image. When the TR and TE is short, it is a T1 weighted image. So after a RF excitation pulse, there is a relaxation of the spin from the transverse plane towards the main longitudinal magnetic field B0. This is T1 weightening. At the same time, spins are decaying from their aligned position in the transverse plane. Differences in this decay are captured on T2 weightening. The amount of T2 decay tissue experience will depend on multiple factors. Each tissue has an inherent T2 value, but external factors such as magnetic field inhomogeneity can decrease the T2 relaxation time. So the magnetic field inhomogeneity is captured on T2 star. The refocusing pulse on spin echo sequence helps to mitigate these extraneous influence on the T2 relaxation time, trying to keep the image T2 weighted rather than T2 star weighted. So this magnetic field inhomogeneity result in T2 star. Paramagnetic contrast agents, example gadolinium containing components, do not cause the same bright tissue contrast as they do on T1 weightening. Gadolinium shortens the T2 relaxation time and actually result in hypointense signal. Hypointense means dark signal. If the T2 is extended out over a very long time, only tissue with a very long T2 relaxation time will retain signal, and this is in the basis of MRCP, that is magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography. So the contrast we are giving in MRI is gadolinium. After giving contrast, we will be taking only one weighted image, and it is a T1 weighted image. And this magnetic field homogeneity is maintained by the shim coil, and that process is known as shimming.
Hope you all are happy with today's session. Today we have seen some of the job offers along with the question and the answers of some of the questions from MRI. Again, I will be including other topics too. So in the upcoming session. And if you have any suggestions or if you want any particular topic to be included, you can mail me. I will be giving my mail address in my description box along with my WhatsApp number. so that you can directly contact me that which all topics will be included. And if you have any questions, MCQs with you, that these questions have to be included. Likewise, if you are having some sort of suggestions, you can either mail me or you can WhatsApp me. So with that, I am coming to the end of the today's session. And if you have any queries or if you require any assistance related with SCPC or related with Kuru or related with any of the topics of our specialty, whatever it is, you can just feel free to mail me or WhatsApp me. And if you are happy with my channel or if you are happy with my class, as I say always, that please share among your friends, colleagues, and please do support me. And those who have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and enable the bell icon too, so that you will receive the notifications of all the videos I am uploading. So patiently wait for my next update. Until then, stay tuned.